JFT Just Fair and Direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 23rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar continued trading slightly higher against the majority of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian morning Thursday. It gained versus NOK, Euro, Kiwi, the Swiss franc and the yen in that order, while it underperformed versus the pound, the Canadian dollar and the Aussie. The greenback traded virtually unchanged against the SEK. The performance in the FX sphere paints a blurry picture with regards to the broader market sentiment. The dollar remained relatively strong and the Kiwi slid, which suggests a risk-off mood. On the other hand, the Aussie gained, while the yen and the franc were slightly lower, which suggests otherwise. Therefore, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world in order to clear things up. Here, major EU and US indices rebounded, ending their session in green territory, with the positive investor morale rolling into the Asian trading session today. The driver behind the improvement in risk appetite was the same which was responsible for the risk aversion in the last couple of days, and this is oil. With no clear catalyst behind the move, oil prices rebounded yesterday, with WTI and Brent gaining 37.66% and 5.38% respectively. The recovery continued during the Asian session today as well. By this time, both benchmarks are up 13.64% and 12.42%. Perhaps oil traders reinitiated long positions on hopes that the OPEC Plus group will eventually decide to extend or even deepen its already agreed production cuts. Remember that the group has already agreed to cut supply by a record of 9.7 million barrels per day starting on May 1st. And also remember that on Tuesday, Saudi Arabia said that it is monitoring the market and is ready to take extra measures to stabilize prices. The big question, though, is whether any extension or new cuts will be enough to offset the diminishing demand due to the coronavirus outbreak. With the restrictive measures around the globe still intact, demand may be set to stay subdued for a while more. Even if governments decide to start loosening their stay-at-home measures, this will probably be a slow procedure, which makes it unlikely for demand to return to its pre-virus levels soon. Thus, we cannot rule out another slide in oil prices if major producers disappoint energy participants. This may result in another round of risk aversion, which means lower equity prices and lower commodity-linked currencies, as well as higher safe havens like the dollar, the yen and the Swiss franc. Now, apart speaking about the broader market sentiment, for another week, investors may pay extra attention to the US initial jobless claims for last week. The consensus is for another 4.2 million people signing up for unemployment benefits following the previous week's 5.245 million. Something like that would push continuing claims up to 16.176 million from 11.976 million and may prompt investors to reduce their risk exposure again, as this would signal that the wounds of the US labor market are really deep. As we noted in the past, paradoxically, the US dollar is likely to strengthen. Lately, the greenback has been reacting positively to disappointing US data, as it has been acting as a safe haven. in a dollar-denominated world during periods of turbulence and uncertainty, investors prefer to liquidate their assets and hold cash instead. Now, apart from the initial jobless claims, we also get preliminary manufacturing and services PMIs for April from several euro area nations and the bloc as a whole, as well as the preliminary US PMIs. Both Eurozone's manufacturing and services PMIs are expected to have declined further into the contractionary territory to 39.2 and 23.8 from 44.5 and 26.4 respectively, something that will drag the composite index down to 25.7 from 29.7. In the US, the manufacturing index is expected to have slid to 38 from 48.5, while the services one is anticipated to have declined to 31.5 from 39.8. Now, another round of declines in the PMIs would enhance the view that the global economic wound due to the coronavirus fast spreading has dragged into the second quarter of the year. Last Thursday, ECB President Christine Lagarde said that she and her colleagues are committed to doing everything necessary within their mandate to fight the crisis, while on March 26th, Fed Chair Powell highlighted that the Fed is not going to run out of ammunition in its attempt to stimulate the economy. So having all this in mind, a disappointing set of PMIs may raise speculation of even more easing by the ECB and the FOMC. The euro could slide alongside the euro area PMIs, but the dollar may be benefited due to its safe haven status, despite the potentially weak US indices. As we already noted, the greenback has been performing well on disappointing US data recently and may continue to do so. Now, with regards to the rest of the data on the agenda, we have the UK retail sales and the US new home sales both for March. The UK headline retail sales are expected to have ticked down to 0.8% year over year from 0.9%, but the core rate is anticipated to have increased to 1.1% year over year from 0.5%. Nonetheless, bearing in mind that the year over year rate of the BRC retail sales monitor for the month slid to -3.5% from -0.4%, we see the risks surrounding the official figures as tilted to the downside. The US new home sales are forecast to have declined 2.2% month over month after falling 4.4% in February. Now, as for tonight, during the Asian Morning Friday, we get Japan's national CPIs for March. No forecast is available for the headline rate, but the core one is anticipated to have declined to 0.4% year over year from 0.6%. The core Tokyo CPI rate ticked down to 0.4% from 0.5%, supporting the notion for a slide in the national core rate, while the headline Tokyo one held steady at 0.4%, suggesting that the national headline rate may have remained unchanged as well. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock a.m. GMT time. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.